Hello and welcome. In our previous lesson, we talked about the Squeeze theorem as far as limits of function and sequence is concerned. We looked at one example, and in this tutorial, we're going to look at another example. So let's look at this example 2. Alright, so we have given weights. Of 1 divided by 7 power n, 9 power n plus 11 power n. So all raised to the power negative 1 over n. So we're finding the limits of that measure. So we are evaluating, we evaluate the limits. So the limit of this as n approaches infinity. So this is what we handle. Okay, so let's see how we do this. Okay, so let's begin with this and see whether we can rewrite this in a different form. Okay, so this can also be written as the limit of that in indices we learn something from indices that when you have A bar B and R is raised to the power, say, negative m over, say, n, for instance. And this is the same as saying that, so when we reciprocate this against SB over A, then the negative sign automatically disappears, so we have m over of n. We want to use that in the experiment and reduce this to look a little bit nice. So we have the limit of this, so we now have 7 power n, 9 power n, and 11 power n. And then, so all this, so as we reciprocate, then the negative sign moves. So we have this as n approaches infinity. So now it's looking familiar, it looks simple now. Alright, so let's go ahead and use the squeeze property to evaluate this. So, using the squeeze property, you need to actually remember under what condition that particular property is applicable. That particular property is used when we have a certain sequence and it is less than or equal to another sequence. Less than or equal to another sequence. Like this. And so, we put whatever we are looking for here. We have 7 to the power n plus 9 to the power n plus 11 power n r is to the power 1 over n. So it's less than or equal to. Less than or equal to. So we want to put another sequence here such that that will be greater than or equal to what we have already. And another one here which will be less than or equal to what is here. So I look around and I, for instance, I put here 11 power n r is the power 1 over n. So you realize that what is here is less than or equal to what is here. Then to this end, we want a larger sequence than compared to this. So we're having, say, 11 power n, then plus 11 power n plus 11 this r is the power 1 over n. So that's it. The condition here will be achieved. So let's look at how we can simplify all that. So from there, it implies that. So with this particular one, so we are raising power to another power, so we multiply. We have n over n, which gives us 1. So we have 11 over n, and less than or equal to. So here we will not simplify it because we don't know what to do with it. So we still maintain this here. So 7 that. So we write it as this. And this will be less than or equal to. But we have 11 power n, 11 power n. So 3 terms here. And 11 power n has occurred twice. So it's common. So I factor 11 power n twice. Realize that we are having 1. Plus 1, plus 1, such that if I expand this bracket, I'll get whatever is here. Now. So all this to the power 1 over n. Alright, so we have here 11 less than or equal to, so this one is still right as it is. 7 power n, 9 power n, then 11 power n, r is to the power 1 over n. So this should be less than or equal to. So here we have 1 plus 1 plus 1 gives us 3. So we now have 11, that's 3 multiplying 11 power n. So all raised to the power 1 over n. Alright, so here we still have this. I'm less than or equal to 9, 11 power n. And 1 over n less than or equal to. So here you're multiplying, so the power here affects both 3 and 11 power n. So this and this gives us 11 multiplied by, so this will give us 3 raised to the power 1 over n. Right. At this point, we find the limits of each of the terms. So limits of 11 as n approaches infinity should be less than or equal to the limit of, so whatever we are evaluating, that is all this as n approaches infinity, and this should be less than or equal to, so this is constant, so it comes out multiplied by the limits of 3 to the power 1 over n as n approaches infinity. Good. So this is constant, and limit of constant is one of the properties of limit. So limit of a constant is a constant itself. So here the result here is 11, which is less than or equal to. You don't know this, so we still write it as we have it here. And then so we have it naturally as n approaches infinity. So this should be less than or equal to. So for this particular one, rather than as n approaches infinity, this particular aspect of the sequence approaches 0. So this one is approaching 0, so we realize that 1 over n approaches 0 as n approaches infinity. So 1 over n approaches 0 as n approaches infinity. Rather, as this is approaching 0, we realize that 3 raised to the power 0 gives us 1. So 1 multiplied by 11, so this is 11 as a result. So now the limit to this side is 11. And the limit here is also 11. So we can confidently conclude that by the squeeze property, the limit of 7 power n plus 9 power n plus 11 power n, r is to the power 1 over n, as n approaches infinity, is equal to 11. Which also is equivalent to writing that the limit of 1 over, so we are writing it in the form that it was, you know, 7 power n, 9 power n plus 11 power n, as n approaches infinity, all this be equal to 11. Alright, good. Thanks very much for watching this particular tutorial. So we'll meet again. Keep calculating and solving questions on introductory analysis. Thank you very much.